Welcome, race fans, to the first race of 2017 in the NRSL. We are here at Chicagoland Motor Speedway, home in Joliet, Illinois, which is not too far away from where all famous Chicago teams played, whether if it's the United Center, U.S. Cellular Field, or just recently won the Chicago Cubs, home of Wrigley Field, where they have won the World Series. We are here for the Xfinity Series race. Here, race number 11 of the season 6 NRSL Xfinity Series, now with the ESPN ticker. We're going to be here for 41 laps, so let's get down to the drivers here. So, John Art is on the pole for today's race. Zach Flickinger will start 2nd. 3rd, it's Todd. 4th, Seth Cole. 5th, Anders Baranska. 6th is Nick Johnson. 7th is Noah Ponser. 8th is Ramey Fisher. 9th, Zachary Fitzmark. In the top 10, it's Austin Mungold. Starting lineup for today's race here at Chicagoland. Let alone me in the commentary booth, this is my home track here in Chicagoland, so expect an exciting race. Nonetheless, also the home of Zach Flickinger in the 8 car. And on the final row, we have Pepper Fingai and the 10 of Joshua Ciccoli. If I said 8, my apologies, the 19 of the cup. I'm picking the cup already. But, nonetheless, first off, welcome to 2017, the first race of the year. And we're continuing Season 6. What a journey, though. In 2016, we had, and I apologize, I haven't had any videos uploaded, let alone recorded, throughout the end of 2016, after that Christmas upload of the throwback race. It was due to time constraint and business job that I was in, and unfortunately that really did not help, and I really hate doing a race where I'm extremely tired and I don't have all the energy as well, so I want to have the energy like I am right now, doing a race, and I'm extremely, extremely energized and hyper. This is also the first time, too, in the NRSL where we're having our ESPN ticker going along in our series. Will it be for race 11 through race 20 and the LCQs of this season? But without further ado, though, let's go down trackside to get those famous words in motorsports presented by Geico.
Drivers, start your engines!
And there's the command to fire them up. A front row sweep, by the way, of Second Keith Motorsports. Will they get the win, though? We will have 41 laps to decide. Everyone rolls on up, all 42 cars. You're seeing all 42 of them rolling on by past turn number 3. As this D-shaped oval is really intense here. Some of the best camera angles, too. John Art, Zach Flickinger, Chris Dodd, Seth Cole.
First 2 rows.
I'm terribly yawning, but who cares? Baranskas and Dollarton in your top 3, and here we in the first 3 rows as well. As the green flag is out, we're underway at Chicagoland. And a nice start by John R. He got going. Zach Flickinger caught sleeping behind the wheels. Chris Dodd trying to go for that 2nd position. Now here's the thing about Chicagoland. You can go 2 wide. You can go 3 wide. 4 wide. Whoa! One car already in the grass. Oh, and that was Sam Curtis and Henry Samper, Matt Dixon. Caution out. I don't know what Sam Curtis was thinking, but he went down to the apron and caused a caution. Oh, no, 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 Gene Samper. Oh, no, that's not good. Oh, no, oh, my God. That is what I feared. Oh, please be smart. Oh, there's jammed up real bad, and Matt Dixon really just plowed Paul Barber in the 6. Sam Curtis followed in. The first race of 2017, some drivers not off to a good start, and I knew that four stack wide there was not going to be a good thing. You see Benjamin Miles, he's trying to get back up to the front of the field. One car coming up at rear, that is Ramey Fisher. He is indeed coming down. Jeffrey Fingai is also coming down. Or, I'm sorry, I say Jeffrey Fingai, I meant to say Ryan Acosta. 29. I think I... Not coming down. Costa down, Mongol down. Carson Gum in the 77. That's running damage. There you see Jonathan Zorl and others who also got held up but didn't make it by. There you see them all the way to Joshua Osborne there. Henry Sanford didn't get them damage from earlier on. There's Batson, Barber, and Dixon. Dixon out of it. Man, his season has just nothing but bad luck. Fisher coming back out on the course. And Sam Curtis, he's calling it quits. Costa and Mongol coming back out. Patson coming on out. Barber will come on out as well. Now we're just going to keep an eye on this pack to see if they will make pit stops. I doubt it because this is lap 3 of 41, but stranger said than done. You never know, though. Looks like nobody else is coming down, so that's a good sign. Caution's out. First time today is when I'm lap 341 heading to lap 4. Let's take a look at what happened to Sam Curtis. And then that four-way battle, that really went south. Well, I was watching this. We have to start from turn 1 and turn 2 because this is what's going to initially cause the caution. Now, he actually clips the 16 as the 54. And the 16 of Paul Minnick saves it. Then Curtis goes down in the cold Deaver in the 3. 54 saves it. That was a good save by Sam. Deaver comes back up the track. He'll be A-okay. However, Sam Curtis, he's in the grass. And he's not going to make 2017 off to a good start. And you notice what normal AI do there. Going into turn 3. Still at a pretty significant speed there. You can tell he's trying to slow down, but it's really not working out. He's slowing down very low there. And then he's going to come up the track, and the first car he comes up and collects, he barely misses Carson Gum, but he nails Batson, Barber, Dixon. Now, at this point, there's actually no caution, but then right there, there's where the caution is going to come on out, because if that moment happened, that would have not been a caution. With Barber and Batson. There you see Dixon. I guess the damage he sustained in that 48 Sega Dodge there, that was enough for him to retire out of the race. Tough break right there for a few drivers there. And then, I don't know what happened here, but look at this. That's Ramien Fisher, Austin Mongol, Ryan Acosta, Benjamin Miles. They're all in a four-wide scenario. And then Jean Sanford had an insult to injury. She actually goes for a wide after they take the caution. I mentioned before, you don't want to take four wide this track. You do not. Unfortunately, these drivers will pay the price. But Jean Sanford and RJ Bishop, they actually make a lucky save right here. Take a look. See a four wide right there. Jean Sanford just about avoids a near disaster at the 91. And then all of a sudden, Benjamin Miles, he kind of pushes up onto Acosta, Mongol, and Fisher, and Miles does not let off. I don't know why the 98 did not do that. The 62 actually just about makes it 5 wide right there. That's insane. Miles just stays on where he's at, doesn't realize the other 3, and then look at the 18 actually catch them there. 2 wheels off the ground, and then there you see the rest of the incident you've seen before. Paul Minnick just about avoids that one. Good job at the 16. Not having a good season at all. And there you see it before the stack up going on. Nick Johnson just about avoids that one. That was a close call right there for the 52. Yeah, Shear went in the wrong area, and that's where he's going to pay the price. And everyone else just trying to hope they chose the right line. Barber runs into Batson, by the way. And then watch Matt Dixon just doesn't slow down enough. Right into the 6. There's the 48. Jacks him up. Goes into Batson. Sam Curtis basically follows in. And adds insult to injury. Let's look what happened, though, for the first caution in today's race. Baranskas, your leader. Let's take it back to the green. Race cards, give us one lap to go. Those two drivers we mentioned before are the only retirees. And that would be Matt Dixon and Sam Curtis. But Baranskas will be your leader. On the restart, second, Chris Dodd. Third, John Arndt. Fourth, Seth Cole. Top 3 rookies right there. Not bad. Noah Ponser 5th, RJ Bishop 6th, Chris Dollerton 7th, Gene Samper, 8th. Zach of Pittsburgh, 9th. Wayne Cartz with a top 10. Only one veteran in the top 10. The next one would be Dylan Throw in 11th. Then you got Paul Mick at 12th. Zach Lickett at 13th. Kyle Matthews, 14th. Johnny Gardner, 15th. Nick Johnson, 16th. PJ Williams, 17th. Grayson A. Toledo, 18th. Brett Pritchard, 19th. Clean the top 20. Ev Shearer. Back up to the front of the field. Green flag back underway for Andres Baranskas. He won a race earlier this season at Ireland. And we'll try to see if she goes for her second win. But Chris Dodd, who's been having such a stellar season in the Skoll Chevrolet, is not wasting any time. He's going to want that lead. Rumors are saying Chris Dodd may have an opportunity to get in Cup next season. Are looking like it. The question is, though, what car will he choose, though? That's going to be the key thing, is you see Baranskas hit that wall. Turn 4 is going to probably be a trouble spot there, as those drivers that are on the outside line do like to hit that wall. And if they like to really lean on each other, bouncing up that wall, that will not be good. See some drivers battle for position there. Oh, no! We got a spin up in the front. That's Gene Samper, John Hart, and this is not good. Oh, no! Angel Navarro! Cars are scattered all over. Connor Meyer, James Qualls, Henry Samper, I think, got involved again. Batson, Barber. Oh, there's a mess. I think Zorland, I think, I just see. Oh, Qualls and Meyer got into each other. Ciccoli, Mongold. Caution will wave again as we're on lap 8 of 41. And the leader they're saying is Chris Dodd. Now they're, I believe, Dylan Thoreau. He's just trying to slow down, but he's going to let Chris Dollerton and Noah Poncer on by. Hoping he can let Poncer on by. I don't know why he's not.
Oh, man, a lot of cars. Ugh.
Barbara Batson back down the pit road. Navarro, Mongold, John R., Gene Samper. Tough break for the 9 of Samper. They're back. Both Sampers in trouble today. Connor Meyer and everyone's coming down pit road. No one is staying out. You see in the pit lane, we're going to go to a spectator so we can get a good view there. Some drivers do stay out, including Chris Dodd, Chris Dollerton, Seth Cole, and Brett Pritchard. We're going to go to Zach Flickinger in the 19, and we're going to put it over to the Dunn camera. John Art leaving his stall. He is going to be a lap down, however. Flickinger with a quick stop. He's in and out. First one off pit road. Carson Gumm, RJ Bishop, Dylan Thoreau, Noah Poncer, Zachary Fitzwater, Kyle Matthews, Ace Vado, Carson, Rogers, James, Gardner, Minnick, Zorland, Keith, Fingai, Shearer, Shelton, Miles. Everybody else coming on off. Andres Baranskas with the slow stop right there. They're trying to repair some of that damage on the right side. That's what they're doing. And off goes the 2. Slow stop, I guess, to repair that damage. And also Henry Samper and PJ Williams repaired service as well. John R. coming back down the pit road again. I guess they're trying to repair the damage. I hope he doesn't have the pit glitch, but the top 4, remember, did not hit. So we're going to keep an eye on those. Caution's out for the second time today. Go take a look what happened. Well, this was right in front of the field, and Seth Cole nearly went 4 wide, and Art thought he was there, so the 42 actually gets clipped by the 60 into the 39, into Dylan Thoreau, who manages to save it, and then the 2 and the 42 bounce off the wall. Gene Samper, nowhere to go, goes right into the 42, and then all hell breaks loose over here. Heard your helicopter. Kyle Matthews somehow gets by that one, found the right hole and gets by. Deaver actually runs in the 55, nearly gets run over by the 048, and then watch everybody else scatter. James Qualls, nowhere to go. He gets involved right there. Angel Navarro, you're going to see. Carson Gumm gets a little piece. There's Ciccoli, Mongold, Connor Meyer. Oh, God, Mongold. I think he just hit the cake of that wall there. That's a terrible lick there. Henry Samper gets by. Wow, the 51 just hit the kink of that wall there. And I don't know what happened to the Meyer and Qualls. Let's take a look at that. What happened here? Did Meyer run into Qualls? Ball's coming down. Meyer wasn't. Oh, he did. Qualls was wanting to come on down. Meyer was like, nah, I'm gonna go back up on the track. And bad miscommunication. That really hurt their cars there. And I think, did they go back to pit road? Nope. Qualls, he still went down pit road. He was committed. We got to go back to Mongol, though. He took a shot to that paint there of that wall. And I think it's safe to say he's done for the day because that was a lick. Just a second, folks. Let me, there we go. My mouse is going a little funny there. But everything's all right. But man, what a lick the 51 took. I think he hit the kink. He did. Watch here again. I can't even get a real good angle here. I don't know. Maybe TV2 works. See that kink right there. Now watch the 51. Yes, he did hit it. Wow, that is a lick. I'm trying to see if we can get a really good view. But I guess not. Actually, let's go. Let's go right here. Now, let's do this here. Now, I'm going to check from here. He did hit it. Keep an eye on that 51. You're going to see that black 51 car. Does he really hit that? Yeah, he did. Okay, see, yeah, right there. You're going to see that car make that jump. Yeah, you're going to see that. He actually hit that kink, and this car actually does get air because of that. And he hit it with the right side of that car. That was just enough. Amazing what camera control, camera movement can do. But you see that kink that enters right here where the safer barrier comes on out. He just hit that, and that car caught air. That is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Let's look what happened. Bring yourselves our second caution for today's race. Let's take it back to the green. Pace cars give us one lap to go. They had a double check with Mongol, but he did say he was alright, so that's a good sight. Out of the race, we do have quite a number of them, including Paul Barber, Keith Patton, Joshua Sicily, James Qualls, Angel Navarro, Connor Meyer, Gene Samper, and if I say Connor Meyer, I'm terribly sorry. Mongol will finish 35th, and Meyer will finish 33rd. So that's a good sign. John Ernst, one lap down in the 32nd position. 31 cards on the lead lap. Chris Dodd is the leader. Second, Chris Dollerton. Third, Seth Cole. Fourth, Brett Pritchard. Fifth, Zach Flickinger. Sixth, Carson Gubb. Seventh, RJ Bishop. Eighth, Dylan Thoreau. Ninth, Noah Ponce. In the top 10, Zachary Fitzwater. It's your top 10, the Chris and Chris Show. Up in the top two. That's something I've never said before. You got an old school Chris Dollerton, versus a new school Chris Dodd, who's been taking the NR leagues by storm, and he's still yet to win, you know, such a prestigious race. The green flag is out here at Chicagoland. And actually, if my memory serves me correctly, I believe Dodd did win a race this season. I am having poor memory as of late, and I believe it is Open Roads? I could be wrong on that. But the Chris and Chris Show are going to be having a challenge from the 60th Seth Cole. Look at Brett Pritchard trying to go four wide for the lead. He's going to back off. Dodd just taps the wall. Everybody else is also having a hard time. Before we got a crash, it's Peronskis, Ramian Fisher, Cole Deaver, and Ace Rogers. As Deaver was just about to have a stellar day. Unfortunately, he gets involved. Caution will wave. These guys are slowing down. I believe the leaders, are they racing back? No, they're not. Another quick caution coming today. This is big, though. Seth Cole took the lead at the right time. He's going to get the bonus points because of that. Or not bonus points. You get what I mean. I'm thinking NASCAR there. And some drivers coming down. Some staying out. About half the leaders, it looks like. At least the top seven, actually top six, are coming down pit road, including ninth place, RJ Bishop. Everyone else is staying out for the moment. So, and the damaged cars are also coming down as well. The Dylan Thoreau will lead that lap. There you see him coming on down. Carson Gumm, 77 trying to get away from those damaged cars. Oh, Zach Flickinger and Chris Dodd made some contact. And Chris Dollerton will lead him down off pit road. Brett Richter there. Stuttering batter. Comes out there. Then Seth Cole, Chris Dodd, Zach Flickinger with a slow pit stop. Now he finally comes on out. You see Ace Rogers, Cole Devers, Barons is going to get out in time of them. No. Beat out Ace Rogers, but not Cole Devers. So caution's out for the third time today. A small incident, but still not good, though, nonetheless. What else is coming down pit road, as we can see? Don't throw to the leader. But take a look what happened to our third caution for today's race here at Chicagoland. Well, John Art plays a culprit victim in this. And Ace Rogers, Kyle Matthews, they're getting held up in this mess. And the 0-4 gets turned. Cole Deaver, nowhere to go. Ramey Fisher, nowhere to go. And the same can be said for Baranskas, who is not having a good day. And this goes from bad to worse for the Shore Lodge Chevrolet. Although the two did lead a lap. Still, it's just going downhill. That was basically it for that caution there. It was a small crash, but not good nonetheless. Seth Cole was the leader of the line. Now Dylan Thoreau to get back to the green. The pace car is giving us one lap to go out of the race after that incident. Include Ramian Fisher. That is the only driver out of the race. And still, John Art, a lap down 31st. That's good for Art. He's hoping more of those guys break up. But Art is causing a problem out there for those drivers in the back. Now, real quick, before we get to the top 10, now Seth Cole was the leader at the restart. He's restarted in, I believe, the 25th position. Now, however, RJ Bishop got ahead of him. Same for Brett Pritchard, restarted 23rd and 24th. Top 10 rundown is Dylan Thoreau, Phil Ponser, Grayson Ace Vito, Zachary Fitzwater, Wayne Carson, Paul Minnick, Johnny Gardner, Brian James, Jonathan Thorland, and Jeffrey Finguy. Now, all those drivers ahead of those drivers I mentioned had stayed out, and they're hoping for another quick caution so they can come back down pit road. Big break up for Dylan Thoreau, though. He's going to, you know, lead a lap. Even though leading laps does not matter, but there's a rumor next season saying that bonus points can come in effect. So a green flag back underway here at Chicagoland. And, oh, John Art going to block the inside. Everyone else trying to use the middle of the high line. And Kyle Matthews not going to get lucky. Shelton was the last car to get around. And, oh, we got to keep an eye on this because this is not going to be pretty. Kev Shear using the high line. They're going to split the 42 in the middle. Matthews and Osborne get by. Oh, and Gum nearly causing a crash with Acosta. They're hanging on for now. It's John Art not playing any favoritism. And Baranskas just got dumped. Oh, and Flickinger just got involved. Caution, I think, is out. And yes, indeed, it is. Oh, and up in the front. Carson in front. Brian James. Dylan Thoreau. They're all on the inside. They're going to be A-okay, I hope. I hope is the key word, and that it will be. Wow, that was right in front of the field. There's Ace Vito. He was also involved, but he got lucky as well. Caution will wave again. Not playing any favorites at all today. And I don't know how Fitzwar somehow made it get by, but man, he's got a lucky charm today, is the Aussie. Brian James, he got really lucky. Same for Dylan Thoreau. Flickinger did get involved. You see a little bit of damage. You're going to see on that right side of that branded Dodge there. You're going to see coming off turn four here on that camera. As there you see, yeah, he's got some damage right there. That's a blow there. He was just about clear. Baranskas just really not having her day. I bet she has got to be upset. All because John Art is just not playing nice at all with the lead lap cars. Noah Ponser's the leader. He basically, all the leaders staying out. Let's take a look what happened to bring ourselves the caution. And then the after caution. Well, you see here, everyone is just trying to find a way to get around the 42. And Cole Deaver just snuck in on the 2, did not see him coming. Yeah, it's just been a racing. The 2 got impatient, tried to go low, didn't see the 3, had a full head of steam. And the 19 thought the 2 was actually going to, you know, not get her, but he slows down. That really paid the price for the 19 car. You see him getting into the wall, right side damage. Now, that's what brings out the caution. So, that was it with that incident. Now, we got to go to the front of the field. Whoa, that's the reason why right there. You can tell by the way that they're racing, that did not look good. And Ace Vito snuck in on the 62. And this really could have gone worse, but a lucky break happened. Ace Vito is going to clip Dylan Thoreau into Wayne Carson, Zorlin, and Brian James. Carson just nearly got Zachary Fitzwater. Fitzwater's got that lucky charm. Thoreau goes into Brian James. They're all sliding in the grass. Jonathan Zorlin also got lucky as well because he was in the grass and he managed to avoid causing trouble there. So lucky break by the 44 there. As you can see, he's all by himself in the grass. And remember what happened to Sam Curtis when earlier on the race when that happened. That did not go well for that 54 car. This time, Zorlin, he only had to deal with like 4 cars, and he actually slowed down just nearly getting to Jessica Schellen, but A-OK right there. Amazing how those three also got it the way of it, too. But then everybody else you see there, even with those cars on the inside, for a minute I thought they were going to come on in and hit them, but lucky break for those drivers there. That's definitely not what they needed. We have to go with, like, far chase mode of Zachary Fitzwater, because I'm telling you, that was a lucky break with that 39 car. And show you how close he got involved, nearly getting involved. So let's show the far chase view. Show you the view on board. Well, at least the camera angle wise. From that corner, but he just kept it together. Wow, that was nifty. Caution's out. Let's take it back to the green. I'm telling you what, the lights are still on right now. I think this time by will be the one lap to go. Jerome Porter Fitzwater. He's had a not bad season. Taking over what was at last in points last season, Austin LaPlante's ride. You know, he's done really well. He won at Hogzilla, got his first win in the NRSL. And, you know, this race, he's been avoiding the accidents, looking A-OK as the lights are off in the pace car. And he just about avoided a wreck that really came his way. And I bet you he had to hold on to that steering wheel tight just to make sure he didn't get involved in that accident. So lucky break for that 39 car of the rookie, Zachary Fitzwater. Keep in mind, this is his first NRSL season that he has ever been to, and this has been long forward that he's been looking forward to. Out of the race after that incident include the following of no drivers. I'm actually surprised because I thought someone, someone could have had it real bad, but all right, that's a good sign. Noah Ponser's the leader. Second is Johnny Gardner. Third, Zachary Fitzwater. Fourth, Jessica Schellen. Fifth, Jeffrey Finguy. Sixth, Kyle Keith. Seventh, Paul Minnick. Eighth, Nick Johnson. Ninth, Kev Shearer. Clean the top 10, Kyle Matthews. Top 20 is Joshua Osborne, PJ Williams, Benjamin Miles, Jonathan Zorlin, Carson Gumm, Brett Pritchard, Seth Cole, Chris Todd, Ryan Acosta, and RJ Bishop. Now remember Pritchard, Seth Cole, and Chris Todd, even Carson Gumm, they restarted in the back of the pack. Well, they're already halfway through, and they're hoping that 42 does not cause an issue with John Hart. We're definitely going to be keeping an eye on him. Pace car comes down the pit road at 23 of 41 coming into the books. I guarantee these drivers are hoping and praying to get around the 42, and they hope that caution, if it does come out, come with less than 10 to go. Green flag back underway. Oh, and Keith really had some trouble getting around his teammate, and he actually finally breaks free. Held him up just enough. Oh my goodness, and up in the front! They're nearly wrecking! And I don't know how they kept it together, but they did! What a save! However, Nick Johnson and others, now they got to work around the 42 and try to find some way to get around him. And oh, dear Lord, that does not look good. Oh, no. Oh, God. God, it's Zorlin flipping upside down. Holy smokes. Zorlin landing on 4 wheels. And I forgot to mention, he's also a Chicago native as well. Oh, my word. And Osborne's upside down. He lands on the first stretch on his roof. God, the Poles, who's having such a good day, he gets involved. Ace Rogers. Oh, my word. Ryan James, I think, got involved as well. Holy mother of pearl, that was a wreck. And I think them two got involved in the kink. Johnny Gardner's the leader. I don't know, but that was a wreck. Ironic enough, that dealt with the 42 again. People are not going to be happy with John Art, and they're actually hoping and praying that the restart comes less than 10 to go. It does not look like it now. Well, John Art is making some great friends, and unfortunately, really, really not helping. Caution's out. Once again, Johnny Gardner leads. John Art causing more trouble. Let's take a look what happened. Welcome back, folks. Because I had to watch the clip again, and I'll tell you what. That was just unbelievable. So you're going to see here, they're 3x3. Osborne just nearly made it 4 wide. And then Chris Dollerton is going to clip Cole Deaver. They both go up the track, go into Chris Dodd. And keep an eye on the 88. Watch that red car. The car actually gets stuck in the wall and makes Zorlin and Osborne fly. Look at the 44 and the 88. Oh my goodness. Osborne doing a reenactment of Casey Atwood's flip, ironic enough. Brian James, is he getting involved? Chris Dodd, from what we got, wonder if he landed upside down, spinning on his roof like a top. Zorlin, we already know what happened to him. Ace Rogers, Wayne Carson. Zach Blickinger avoided most of the accidents. He gets involved right there. Unbelievable. That was not what I expected at all. There you see Osborne. He just slides on his roof, crosses the start finish line. Unbelievable, though. We have to go to Jonathan Zorlin. We have to. I'm going to try to see where a real good angle is. Let's see if we can do that again there. Now watch. Let's see where if we can find that moment where Dodd gets stuck. Look at the height of that, though. Unbelievable. Okay, now let's see if we can actually try to get a real good angle. Let me see, though. Can we do... Alright, we're going to go to Far Chase again. Let's just see from the 88. So, let's back this up. Okay, keep an eye. Watch frame by frame. There you see there. Did he get stuck or... I think he got stuck in the wall is what happened. And then it rocketed the 44 into the 27, and the 88 and the 44 went airborne. 88 actually also hit the catch fence there, and... Oh, that was a lick. Unbelievable accident, though. Turn 4. Once again, causing it some trouble there. Caution's out. Let's take it back to the green. So the pace car is giving us one lap to go yet again. We got more retirees out of that race after that accident, including Carson Gumm, Jonathan Zorlin, Henry Sanford, Chris Dodd, Dylan Thoreau, Ace Rogers, Joshua Osborne, Brian James. On our lap down 23rd, he's got to be the one really happy with everyone else wrecking. But, man, I bet you, though, this may be the last opportunity John Art may have with these lead lap cars. So if another caution comes out, you know, then whoever's behind Art, they're in trouble. And they are in serious trouble. So Johnny Gardner is your leader. Noah Ponter second. Fitzwater third. Shelton in fourth. Allman in fifth. Jeffrey Fingai sixth. 7th is kept here, 8th Kyle Keefe, 9th Andrew Miles, and P.J. Williams completing the top 10. What a run the 55 is having, a good comeback. Green flag back underway, the 42 as usual off the pace, top 4, top 5 get on by Jeffrey Fingai just at the last second, went to the outside line, nearly getting into the 42's way. However, wow, Brett Pritchard got stuck behind his teammate. Not a good teammate, not a good driver, as Bishop nearly turned the 43. Everyone else trying to get around, Ryan Acosta being the poor loser in that one, and unfortunately, Acosta's really not too happy about this one. Still trying to get around that 42. He's still stuck behind the 42. He's dedicated to being behind that 42 car. He's just not wanting to get off that bumper. And now the 29's trying to clear. And he nearly just turned him. I think he sent him a message saying, hey, get out of my way. Still blocking. That 42 is really not letting Ryan Acosta on by. He slips, and now Acosta finally breaking free. Back up to the front of the field, though. Jessica Shelton leading her first lap of the race. Johnny Garner trying to get back that lead. Paul Medic, Chicago native, in the second position. Three Chicagoans in this field alone. Keep in mind, in the Cup Series, we're going to have Tanner Sullivan, who's also another Illinois native there, in this race. Minnick won't be in this one. Neither will Zorlin. Gardner will get the second spot. Paul Minnick trying to do a crossover. And we'll try second once again. Big news for Jessica Shelton, though. She's going to try to run away from those leaders as quickly as possible. Now, the good news, because everyone got around that 42 car A-OK, that caution comes out, everyone will still have that chance battling for that win. Minnick trying to get on that inside line. Gardner did get the wall a bit. That's going to help that 16 get around the 22. He will get the second position. All this, though, behind the 20 car of Jessica Shelton. Looking for another win in her Outback Xfinity Series resume there. And that move to the 20 really has helped her out. She has not looked back from that 9 car. And you can tell with Jean Sanford struggling, she has got to be extremely happy she is not in that position. And Gardner once again trying to go for second. They keep Ballard behind the 20, and that's allowing Shelton to run away. And Wayne Carson, though, could be a factor with these leaders. Gardner maybe again. Carson, you can tell, is slower than the lap car. And now we may have a new second-place driver. It's the New York native, Benjamin Miles. And Kyle Keith coming as well in the 24. Taking over that ride for Kate Anderson there as Gardner hit the wall. Here comes the other discount tire, Ford. This one a Ford being of Jeffrey Finn guy. And Miles looking for that lead. He's trying to look underneath that GameStop Mortal Kombat Toyota there. Just can't seem to get that run. However, that lap car, they are approaching him. Jones also has had a bad history with lap traffic and numerous races in the past. This may come to haunt her again. Here we go. We are encountering Wayne Carson in the 98. Is she going to pick the right line? She picks the right line this time, and she says sayonara to Benjamin Miles. Oh, and they're all getting held up from second on back. Keith and Miles, everyone trying to scatter around the 98. Minnick and others trying to do what they can to get around. Look at Seth Cole and Grayson Ace Vado fly out of nowhere. Cole gets some evidence. Gardner around. I don't know who else is involved. I seen Cad Shearer. I think I seen Paul Minnick. He's upside down the 16. And the hometown native has crashed hard. Gardner smoking. Cad Shearer. Paul Minnick actually still driving somehow. That may be the end of his chance for the win, let alone the race. Chris Dollerton also involved. Noah Ponser. Caution will wave. Shelton is still the leader. And nobody else, from what it looks like, is coming down pit road. One car I see trying on the inside line trying to get a spot, I believe, was Ponser. Now, there's Wayne Carson. The top 10 managed to get around the 98 after they crossed the stripe. And we're also at that point where we're nearly getting to the end of the race. So we may have a green-white checkered, let alone three laps to go to finish this race. I'm not too sure, but I have a feeling it may be a green-white checkered. Jessica Shelton, though, is your leader. And a tough blow for the hometown native. Big fan supporter Paul Minnick there. Definitely not what he needed. He was also struggling in the points. Have Shearer, Johnny Gardner. Minnick, let alone, flipped over. Macy was still driving, and he is done for the night. So his run in Chicago is going to come to an end. However, there's one more race in Illinois that we have that Minnick will try to redeem, and other than that, that's a Sad exit. Sad exit for Paul Mason. 16 is looking real good, too. Avoiding all the crashes. Unfortunately, it's going to come to an end. Sheldon is the leader. Let's go take a look. What could be your final caution of today's race? Let's see what will happen. What happened. Let alone this was after the fact they had passed Wayne Carson in 98. Keep an eye on the discount tire cars here. The Ford of Finn Guy in the 12, the 22 Dodge of Gardner. Gardner actually clips the 12. The 22 then gets clipped by the 5. It's just a chain reaction and just bad place, wrong time. Paul Minnick also on the outside line, not a good place to be. That's another tough break for Gardner there. Oh, Paul Minnick just nowhere to go when that happened. And I have no idea who flipped him. Somehow Wayne Carson gets by, and I think that may be Chris Dollarson you're going to see in that picture. With the help of Kev Shear, he's going to flip the 16 over, and that's what's going to end his day right there. He's enough to Wayne Carson because of that. Kind of trolled the field there. He got around Nick Johnson, Noah Ponser, and Grayson H. Vado. But was it a little too late, though? Sheldon is the leader. Let's take it back to the green. Was it indeed a green-white checkered out of the race after that incident? We got Paul Minnick, who will finish 23rd. Johnny Gardner, 22nd. Chris Dollarson, 21st. And Noah Ponser will finish top 20 out of the race. And how about John Hart up to 19th and Wayne Carson to 18th? Unbelievable runs. However, I think John Hart may beat Wayne Carson, but who knows? 17 cars in the lead lap. 2 laps ago, it's going to come down to the top 10. Jessica Sheldon, your leader. Kyle Keith, 2nd. Benjamin Miles, 3rd. Jeffrey Fingai, 4th. Kyle Matthews, 5th. Zachary Fitzwater, 6th. RJ Bishop, 7th. Brett Pritchard, 8th. PJ Williams, 9th. And there's your 10th place car, Seth Cole, in that position. And behind him, who are on the pace, are Nick Johnson, Grayson H. Spado, Zach Flickinger, and Ryan Acosta. 4 cars. Everybody else is damaged and off the pace. They're somehow still, managed to keep going. As green flag, back underway Chicagoland. Green, white, checkered. I think Keith and Miles, they may have missed that opportunity unless a crossover happens. And here comes the Target Chevrolet. Or Dodge, rather, excuse me. I'm used to saying Chevrolet because of the team. The Target Dodge going to the inside. Jeffrey Fingai, remember, he got clipped, but Gardner, he's still continuing. Could he make a move for that win? Sheldon trying to use that outside line, trying to use it to her advantage. Not going to work. Keith with the lead. White flag coming displayed for Kyle Keith in the 24 car. 1 lap to go for the Target Dodge. Is anyone going to get that 24? Here comes Kyle Matthews for 2nd 3 wide. That may have just killed the momentum, and that may have helped the 24 for victory. No one's got a chance for that 24 car. He timed his move perfectly, and he took the lead, and that's all she wrote. Kyle Keith off the final turn is going to be victorious. His 2nd win of the season. He wins at Chicagoland. His 2nd career Xfinity Series victory, or actually his 3rd, excuse me, his 2nd of the season. What a job right there. Nick Johnson got the 10th position, and just about everyone got around that 98 there. John Hart just missed the opportunity to beat Wayne Carson, but what a race though, nonetheless, though. And Kyle Keith, good to go for the sweep in the Cup Series later on. And oh, we got some tempers flaring. That's Grayson Ace Vado and Jeffrey Finn guy. Putting each other off there. But Keith, victorious for the 2nd time this season, 3rd in his career. So, there you see your top 10. Here's your results. As I actually hit my volume button for stupidity there. But there, like I mentioned before, your top 10, your results. So, there they are. Other than the top 10 that you have seen, the rest of the drivers that finished the race include Zachary Fitzwater, Grayson Ace Vado, Ryan Acosta, Zach Flickinger, Andres Baranskas, and Cole Deaver, plus Kev Shearer. That was your top 17 that finished the race on the lead lap. Carson and Arndt finished the race a lap down in 18 and 19. Everybody else, as mentioned before, out of the race. Well, thank you guys for watching the first race in 2017. If you like, to be sure to give it a like, comment your thoughts, and subscribe to the NRSL by hitting that subscribe button. And we will see you guys later on for more NRSL content here on the channel. Till then, goodbye everybody from Chicagoland, and we'll see you for the Cup race.